Some of the questions that have been posed about this piece over time are, what is really descriptive about it? For example, in spring or summer or autumn or winter, are there really, is Vivaldi actually really describing those seasons through the music? And not 100% of the time, but in very many cases, the answer needs to be yes, he is. He's being very descriptive, in fact, programmatic. The term program music, which some of you may know already, refers to music that is describing something that received its inspiration from something that was non-musical and to begin with. In this case, one of the seasons. So, for example, in summer, the piece begins with this very languid, and it's meant to make you feel like that the whole time, which I think Vivaldi does quite effectively. Contrast that with winter, that begins like this, and that's little shivers. So that's pretty obvious as well. But going back to summer, the first thing that the violin does sounds like just virtuoso music. But if you break out the part that's not all the repeated notes up here, take that away, you get cuckoo, cuckoo, cuckoo. Well, that's not hard to figure out, because right above the that part of the piece is a part of the poem that Vivaldi set these to. We're not sure whether he wrote the poem or not. And it says, the cuckoo sings loudly. So, okay, that's an easy one to put. Be more difficult if it was a nightingale, perhaps. But the cuckoo's an easy one to put in there. Then moving ahead, keeping with the program idea, how about autumn? Right, there's a part of the poem that says, the drunkard drinks deeply from the cup of Bacchus. Well, after you've drunken a fair amount of wine or any other spirit like that, what do you end up doing? Hiccup, and you get this. Right in the music, absolutely no problem at all. In summertime, of course, there are often thunderstorms. Beethoven's thunderstorm in the Sixth Symphony, the Pastoral Symphony, is perhaps the most famous thunderstorm ever written into music, but this is maybe, if not as famous, maybe just slightly less famous. And you hear things like this. This is called thunder. The skies are dark, lightning flashes, and thunder roars. That's from the poem. Here's how Vivaldi set that musically. That's clearly lightning, which I kind of like the idea that even these composers from antique times, way before Benjamin Franklin and all of that, had figured out that lightning starts from the bottom and goes up to the cloud, not the other way around. So that's some lightning there. And later on in the summer piece, you have the flowered meadow with the goat herd and the dog. Well, the main melody you hear here is this gentle little triadic theme, goes like this. Underneath all of that is the viola going. It's not a very demanding part, but it's pretty critical for the poem, because this is bow wow. It's the dog. Okay, it's given to the viola part. Let me give you one more example of this. How about teeth chattering with a cold? It's about as chattery as you can get a violin to be. So, all the way throughout these pieces are many, many moments when, if you read the poem, which I believe is in the concert program, you will be able to understand what is going on in the piece at the same time, and it's not a large stretch of the imagination. It makes it pretty fun.